time then. Unlikely anyone would remember exact date or when did it happen. Still, all what you are going to see today is true. There are two brothers, Hiranyakashipu and Hiranyaksha, best from the dynasty of Asuras. Daily they practice martial arts in their palace for their purpose to conquer the world. Hiranyakashipu been performing the most severe austerities human ever performed. And for that terrible austerity, he got blessing of Lord Brahma, that not in day, nor in night, not on the land, not in the air, not inside the building, not outside, he would not be killed, not by human, not by animal, with any weapon. By getting this blessing, Hiranyakashipu seemingly became immortal. So full of new hopes, he is coming back to the palace. While he is performing his austerities, it is Queen Kayadu in the palace who is pregnant and waiting for baby to be born. But suddenly the heart of the queen started to beat faster, as telling that something going wrong. Made of Kayadu look out in the window and saw innumerable chariots and warriors coming to the palace, some of them flying in the air, led by young creatures, some on excellent chariots, some comes from the old world, but there are the demigods coming.
Patient.
sensing in my eternity, every word, and hopefully absorb the knowledge. This conversation continued for many months. So while Narada been instructing the queen, Hiranyakashipu finished his austerities. And Hayatko delivered beautiful baby, raised in a palace as a king. He was taught by the best students of Asura dynasty in Asura Gurukul. So when king was home, it was the time to present baby to the father. еще ходил. Еще ходил. And he ran a kashiko to his ring filled with poison. Then to queen that if Pilat is not gonna to be changed, she is supposed to give him a poison. In Gurukul decided to make some endeavors to change Pilat. Sarda and Amarka told about everything to the king. And king ordered Kayata to follow his instruction, what he originally gave. Thank you. with protection of the Lord. All troubles in the life of the devotee have been just moment like a nightmare. Hiranyakashipu tried to kill his holy son so many times, but each and every time it failed. Snake, poison, men, elephants, and weapon, nothing could harm him. Like if some invisible power would protect the old child, he dared to worship the Supreme Lord, opposite the will of his father, the demon. Came Kulika, his sister, who was very expert in magic. When she knew about her brother's difficulties, she offered a wrong plan to finish it, and Kulika narrated her story. When she was young, she had become severe spirits to get blessing of Fire God. She donated her flesh with the most terrible tapas. She stayed without food and even water in a fire. As a result, she got a boon to be able to call fire anytime, just by what? Agni! 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 And also she brought a wonderful blessing that no fire could hurt her. Really her enemies would be burned into of God for Prahlad on the top of a mountain, on the bank of the ocean. And he ordered his rakshasas to wash. If ocean wouldn't wash Prahlad down, they have to throw Prahlad into the water.
Should I check in this pillar or this?
Продолжай драться, продолжай драться, рано. To the Lord. They will gather in Him in humility. By teaching Jared to come closer. So they asked Narada Muni to help. And Narada Muni said that we have to put small for light. Only He can make Lord peace. Of black.